today's lab, we're going to be looking at electrophilic aromatic substitution reactions. Specifically, we're going to be doing a Friedel-Crafts type reaction. We're going to use ferrocene as our nucleophile and the acetic acid as our acetylation agent. We're using acetic anhydride because it's safer to handle than the acetyl chloride, which is a more common one you'll see in notes and stuff. We're going to be targeting to make this target acetylation product where we add one group to it. A little bit about ferrocene. It's considered a super aromatic type compound. Each of these rings actually have an anion distributed through the five carbons, which makes them very reactive and a strong nucleophile. So this total reaction will take about 15 minutes to isolate. This is the main product. Okay, so this is the reaction. We set it up with 1 millimole of ferrocene, or 186 milligrams. To that, then we added 2 milliliters of acetic anhydride and 0.4 milliliters of the phosphoric acid. We're going to set the temperature to 3 to 4, stirring it vigorously so we get a homogeneous type of mixture. We have a reflux set up, so water is running. Using a pan to hold everything together so it doesn't fall. And also having the hot plate elevated so that if there's a instance where it gets too vigorous, we can lower it very quickly. We'll take our pots at 5 minutes and 10 minutes to monitor the progress of the reaction, and then we'll check TLC at the end against the crude product and the ferrocene starting material to see how it looks. Okay, so 15 minutes have passed. We took out 5 and 10 minute little outpots in DCM, and you notice the color change from a light bright orange to a dark red brown or red almost black kind of orange color. We're going to shut off the heat, lower it down, and then we'll work it up. Okay, so after 15 minutes, we neutralize the reaction by first pouring into ice, which will help dilute and cool the reaction. Then we add sodium hydroxide to neutralize the phosphoric acid that we add and the acetic acid that is produced as a byproduct. Then we'll get this nice orange solid. We can filter it, wash it with a little cold water, and let air cool on it to get another orange solid right here. Okay, so for our TLC spotters, are it. This is the 5, 10, 15, and then just ferrocene. You can notice how it gets progressively more orange compared to ferrocene being quite yellow. And then when you look at the TLC, okay. So we took TLC spotters, and we spotted the TLC. When you look at the picture of the TLC, you'll see that the ferrocene will be at the very top, and the product spot will be about 0.25 from the baseline. We're having our value of 0.25. Approximately. And you'll kind of see that the ferrocene is consistently at the top, but the product spot does come in darker and darker, where it's the darkest at